We'll start off with a look at some of the snowfall, and this is combined snow and sleet yesterday. Bridgeton, 2.5 inches, 2.1 in Gray, Lewiston, 1.3, Hope, about 1 inch, and Portland, 0.5 inch. Not very much, but enough to cause problems with some accidents reported yesterday and slippery driving. 28 degrees in Portland right now, Gorham as well. It's 28 in Sanford. We have 32 in Kittery and Portsmouth, 33 in Wells. Up to the north, a scattering of teens here, especially Roxbury, Waterford, down to Fryeburg, mid to upper teens. Then we get back into the 20s in the mountains, as Rangeley is 24, even 31 in Errol right now. So not that cold out there by mid-December standards now. 20 degrees in Jay and Augusta. It's 18 in Waterville, and in Lewiston, Auburn, we have 21. Out to the east, Wiscasset is 23, 25 degrees in Rockland. So here's how things play out today. Again, we're going to be watching a rapid moving area of light snow. Low pressure develops along our front that passed through yesterday. It's going to be far enough out to sea that we just get brushed by this. So I think we could see a little bit of accumulating snow in York County this afternoon. Maybe brushing the islands and tips of the peninsulas here with a little light snow or snow shower activity. Other than that, though, we'll clear things out tonight. Tomorrow we'll start off with some sunshine, then we'll see some clouds develop as an Arctic front gets closer to the area. That will come through tomorrow night, and boy, we'll know it by late tomorrow night and Thursday as bitter cold Arctic air moves in. Might be our coldest day of the season so far, I believe, on Thursday. Small craft advisory this morning, actually till 2 o'clock this afternoon. Westerly winds 10 to 20 knots, seas 3 to 5 feet, visibility 1 to 3 nautical miles. So today we're going to see a lot of clouds around and a little bit of light snow in the far south. And also we'll see, again, some flurries maybe brushing the coastline here. This is not a big deal, but you know, just something to be aware of. Inland areas, I think, will escape with virtually nothing here. And overnight tonight, we'll see clearing skies and temperatures drop to the teens, single digits in the north. And it looks like as we look ahead at our exclusive 8-day forecast, we are going to see those temperatures in the low 30s tomorrow, but they'll fall like a rock late in the day. Some snow showers in the afternoon and bitter cold for Thursday. Really not warming up much over the weekend, and we could be talking about maybe a heavier accumulation of snow Saturday evening into Sunday.